والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is your brother Abdul Salam Abu Hanifa. Today is pep talk number 8, and this is going to be our sins. It's going to be about our sins. So many of you write and say, I have committed a lot of sins, and I fear that Allah is going to punish me, and I am a sinner, I am this, I am that. Let me tell you something that doesn't get talked and told to us that often. Actually, every day, or maybe every khutbah, or every, at least you hear it every time you go to the masjid, that we commit a lot of sins and we must repent to Allah and we are doomed, and that's it. Again, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ummuna Aisha radiallahu anha, as in al-Bukhari and Muslim, when the accusation of Ummuna Aisha to have committed a zina. And always remember, my brothers, every time you hear something about somebody, you time it by 1,000. Because Ummuna Aisha radiallahu anha lost a necklace that she borrowed from her sister. She lost a necklace and she went looking for it, only to be labeled a fornicator. Again, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it got really intense and for a whole month he didn't hear anything from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the pressure of the community. And again, as I said yesterday, number 7, about the Sahaba, so many of them, actually, about 10 of them were of the carriers of the lies about Ummuna Aisha radiallahu anha. One of them was the son of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anha, anhu, who used to, wal-iyad billah, speak against our mother Aisha radiallahu anha. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Aisha around the day 28 or 29, he told her, "Amma ba'd, ya Aisha," because he said, "Inna alhamdulillah, nahmadu wa nasta'inu," and he says, "Amma ba'd, ya Aisha." After all the introduction, ya Aisha, فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ بَلَغَنِي عَنْكِ كَذَا وَكَذَا. I have heard, or it has reached me, that on you this and this. إِنَّمَا أَنْتِ مِنْ بَنَاتِ آدَمَ. You are only one daughters of Adam alayhi salam. Wallahi, he's a beautiful man. Wallahi, he's a beautiful man. فَإِنْ كُنْتِ بَرِيئَةً فَسَيُبَرِّئُكِ اللَّهُ. If you are innocent, then Allah will innocent you in front of him. وَإِنْ كُنْتِ أَلْمَمْتِ بِذَنْبٍ. And if you أَلْمَمْتِ أَلَّمَمْ. You know when you eat bread, toast bread, and you put it in the toaster, and then it becomes dry, and it leaves those small, I forgot the name of them, the piece of little, piece of, that's al-lamam. So when you go and pick it up, look, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking to Ummuna Aisha. She who has been accused of fornication, and he tells her, if you have committed something, al-lamam, it's like you collected pieces of bread, subhanAllah. فَاسْتَغْفِرِ لِلَّهِ فَاسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهِ. Make istighfar to Allah and tubi, and repent back to Allah. فَإِنَّ الْعَبْد. So the subservient, when he, إِذَا اعْتَرَفَ بِذَنْبِهِ, if he acknowledges his sin, then ثُمَّ تَاب, then repents to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts his repentance and restores him back to how he was before the sin. So there you go. This is like a big statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then another hadith also by in al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, and this hadith is sahih as well. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "An-nadamu at-tawbah." Regret is repentance. وَالتَّائِبُ مِنَ الذَّنْبِ. And the one who returns back or reverts back from the dhimb, from the dhamb, كَمَنْ لَا ذَنْبَ لَهُ, is like that who doesn't have a sin. In English, we only have the term sin, but in Arabic, we have a variety of words. One of them is ذنب. What does ذنب mean in Arabic? It's come from the tail. A ذنب is the tail of an animal, that is the tail. Meaning, when a human being does an act, evil act, that is by Allah's standard, is evil, then it's almost like they have grown a tail, a sequence or consequence to their deed. The only way to repent is to cut off that sin, and that is what repentance does. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and my sisters, in the Quran says, فَمَنْ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ظُلْمِهِ وَأَصْلَحَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. فمن تاب من بعد ظلمه, so whoever reverts back, this is تاب, reverts back, من بعد ظلمه, meaning before you committed a sin, you had a status. As soon as you commit a sin, you leave the status. When you repent to Allah, يتوب, التوبة means what? Revert. And this is where you can use I am a revert, because you have reverted back to the status before committing the sin. And how do you do that? How do you revert back to where you were before you committed the sin? By acknowledging your sin and do what? And repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then وَأَصْلَحَ, and then he does good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his reverting. And إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, غَفُورٌ فَعُولٌ, meaning continuously forgives, and رَحِيمٌ on the day of Qiyamah. My brother and my sisters, do not think of yourself as someone as an angel. This we again, we are being fed, like, let's say, if you disobey Allah, you screwed, you, that's it, it's your end of your life. It's not that, is that at all. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in an authentic hadith says, لَوْلَا أَنَّكُمْ تُذْنِبُونَ, were it not that you committed sin, لَخَلَقَ اللَّهُ خَلْقًا, Allah would have created a new creation. يُذْنِبُونَ, they commit a sin, and they will ask for forgiveness, and Allah forgive them. My brother and my sister, your sins are a sign you are a human. Don't you be fooled or brainwashed that say, once you are Muslim, you are not entitled to sins. That's absolutely nonsense. There is, if Allah wanted us not to sin, He would have either created us angels, or He didn't create shaitan. Why did Allah create shaitan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He creates us, He has written on me and on you our level of sins. We all will commit a sin. Anyone who acts like he is sinless is a pure liar. That's why a gift to the prophets, al-isma. Al-isma is the shielding from sins. The prophets, if Allah didn't shield them from committing sins, they would have committed sins. There is no way that a human being on earth wouldn't commit a sin. Many of you ask me, I have done this, I have done that. Let me tell you something about the sins. Sins, consider this. Sins are like the sweat, the bad sweat, your bad mouth odor, when you stink, when you're dirty. What do? You go take a shower. Don't you feel good after you take a shower and you take a bath? And suddenly for a week you are clean. And then you get dirty again. And then you take a shower and you clean yourself. But notice how when you clean yourself you feel good, you look good. And that is exactly what the sins are. Look at yourself today. Are you happy with who you are? Yes, I am happy with who I am. Well, guess what? The sins you have committed have helped you shape, to get shaped into who you are today. Don't you think that the sins are evil all the way through? No. How do you get extra rewards? How do you cry to Allah? How do you love Allah? How do you know your true value? It's through sins. Don't you think that the sheikh who's got a long beard doesn't sin? That's a big lie. There is a difference between acting and being. A lot of people act out there, they are sinless. But in their being, they are sinless. My brothers and my sisters, look at your past. Look at those sins you have committed. And you have repented to Allah about them. Forget them and move on. A shaitan would like to create doubt in your heart that Allah has not forgiven you and you are messed up. That's what he wants. Yes, you've committed zina. Yes, you drank alcohol. Yes, you had drugs. Yes, you did usury. Yes, you did what you did, whatever you did. If Allah wanted to punish you, He could have killed you right after you committed the sin. But because He gave you life after the sin, that means Allah wants you and loves you to revert back to Him. Your duty is to revert back to Allah. The sins is what makes you the great person you are today. Without the sins, there is no human without the sins. Even the prophets are shielded from the sins. So again, my brothers and my sisters, you are entitled to sins. I'm not encouraging you to do sins. What I'm saying is we are entitled, meaning it is Allah who has written on us that we will sin. If we didn't sin, Allah would have killed us all and brought other people. They would sin, and then they will ask Allah for forgiveness. He will forgive them, and they will forgive him. One last point before I close this pep talk here. Don't you ever, never, ever, if you know of a sin of somebody, don't you keep it against them and blackmail them. And if they do something, you sinned. Do you know why? Because that person has sinned indeed, but they repented to Allah. Allah has forgiven them. The sin is wiped out and turned into a good deed. Who are you to keep bringing a sin that Allah has forgiven? Because every time you do that, woe unto you, woe unto you, woe unto you. Allah has forgiven him, her, and you have not. Who are you? What gives you the right to play a god? My brothers and my sisters, all of us sin just like all of us fart. Ain't no human out there who doesn't fart. So let's not make a joke on other people when actually we do too. Our sins have made us who we are. We repent from them and we move on. As shaitan wanna keep you on the past, don't fall into his trap. Me, just like you, has wind. And you, like me, has a progress into this life, and we are moving forward. You can win, and we will win. As long as you know you are a human being, and you will sin, but your job, be like your father Adam, acknowledge your sin, repent to Allah, and have in your heart that you will not return to the sin and move on. Again, a lot of people tell us that one of the conditions of the sin is you must be 100% you're not going to come back to it. Because if you come back to it, that is not a true revert back to Allah, and that is completely rubbish. Because there are so many hadith out there, and I'll deal with them later on, inshallah, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explicitly said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ إِذَا أَذْنَبَ ذَنْبًا قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي فَغَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. And in the long hadith is, a man commits a sin, he says, my Lord, forgive my sin, and Allah says, I have forgiven. Then he comes back to the sin again. And then he says, ya Allah, forgive me, and I will forgive, and Allah forgives. And Rasulullah has mentioned that status for 3 or 4 times. What it matters is at the time of the repentance, you must be deep in your heart. You don't want to come back to it, and you actually don't want to come back to it. And if it happens again, guess what? Renew your tawbah. As long as you do your tawbah, you are in safe hands and you are still in the mercy of Allah. So as of today, treat yourself as a human being, sin and repent. I'm not saying go sin, but what I'm saying is because it's written on you to sin and you will sin. But the most important thing, revert back to Allah and stay as pure as you can and never ever lose hope that you have sinned in the past and Allah will punish you for 10 years' sins. That's absolutely nonsense. How many times have you asked Allah to forgive you? So don't you ever doubt Allah, as I said earlier in one of the talks. Allah is what you make out of Him. If you think Allah has not forgiven you, then He will not forgive you. I personally, for whatever I have done in my entire life, and believe me, collectively all of you won't reach my sins. But I have, alhamdulillah, repented and I moved on. They make me the person that I like to be today, and I am moving on. And so should you. Have a wonderful second day of the week, and Allah bless you all. Wassallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad, subhanak allahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. And have a wonderful day, my brothers and my sisters. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Your brother, Abdus Salam Abu Hanif.